Okay, so Free Flight Panic, it's a game by Ben Yahtzee Kershaw, the guy who's behind the Escapist magazine and Zero Punctuation and all that good stuff. It's one of his games, it's his first game that he had made during his little Dev Diaries thing, because he used to start and end games all the time, and he wants to stick with it and actually finish programming a game, so he's challenged himself to do one game every month, and this is the first one he released. If you've ever been annoyed by anybody on a plane, this game is kind of for you because you get your revenge on them, kind of. It'll start with having their seatbelts unbuckled, then they'll have their phones out, then they'll be leaning back, and then there's a whole. It's basically kind of like Where's Waldo. But without any further ado, I will go ahead and clear my progress. Also turn the game down quite a bit. There's going to be a lot of click clacking because of the keyboard and such, but other than that, hopefully I can maybe hopefully describe it while I'm playing, because I need a lot of focus on trying to find everybody. At the very beginning, it's not going to be very many people, but towards the end, I really need to focus, or otherwise it's several minutes of time loss. All right, 3, 2, 1. So if you don't get it right and you hit the wrong person, you'll get that little question mark, which slows you down for about 3 seconds. And luckily, we got everybody on there. Oops. So the tell with the people that don't have their seatbelts on are that they're going to be wiggling around a bit. And it's just, there's. They're not seatbelted in, so they're just going to be wiggling around. Awesome. We made it. You kind of want to work back to front and not miss anybody, but sometimes I find it a little bit easier if I do intentionally skip some people so I know that they're moving. Because sometimes I don't think that they are. So now these are the people that have their phones out, and they're going to be the exact opposite of the guys with the seatbelts. They are going to be staying absolutely still. And they are the biggest pain to know whether or not you've gotten them all or not. Looks like right. I'm gonna just take a quick peek. But the phones, in my opinion, and almost everybody else's opinion who's ever played this game, is that they are the trickiest to spot, because most of the time you will take off and there will be one phone left. Just double checking. And the plane takes off and takes the same amount of time every time, and it will crash at the same point every time. Oh, we haven't actually seen that yet, so minor spoilers if I ever mess up, which undoubtedly will happen eventually. But so far so good, no crashes so far. These little gold stars are just to show that you have finished within a certain arbitrary little time limit that the game auto-generates based on how many people it puts together. Looks good. Because there's a range of people that it can spawn in with problems. But it also just auto-generates the time limit as well. Oh, then there are people like this guy who can have both problems at once. And that's not very fun. Because you'll just think they only have one issue. Oh, now they're talking about buzzers. Buzzers! They'll have the little exclamation point over their head, and they will become a problem. Oh, that's a problem. One passenger had their cell phone out. Okay, like I said, cell phones are the biggest pain, especially when they're being held by somebody with a dark shirt. good to me. So yeah, that's what happens if you have one person out of line, so you want to make sure that they're all good before you take off. Oh, now it's the ones that are leaning back. So if you've ever sat behind somebody that leaned back their chair, this one's for you. This looks like they have double chins as well. It's kind of funny, honestly. Whoops. Buzzers. I started to mention them, and I didn't finish. If you don't answer their little buzzer, they will turn into a problem, and it'll either be that they're leaning back in a seat or on the phone. And if they turn into a phone one, there is a chance that they will not look like all the other phone ones, and they'll just have the phone out. Which kind of sucks. So you'll think you got them, but because you're looking at them for their face, mostly, that's how I kind of tell. Because anybody on their phone's looking straight down, or straight in front of them, I guess. But sometimes they'll actually be looking out the window if they're a problem, and they take their phone out. The most gluttonous appearance is when they're laying back and they have their phone out. That looks just like anybody at home. Get that guy. I think we're good. Okay, we're good. It's a giant Where's Waldo, and it's very, very stressful. Oh, he's had two problems. Looks good to me, besides this guy. Buzzers, you can actually leave before you answer them, because if you get out before they turn into a problem, they don't count. Oh boy, now red eyes. Red eyes, they are buzzers on steroids. You don't want to upset a red eyes. I'm gonna make sure everybody up here is fine. Guy with the black shirt and the phone. Oh, red eyes, I don't wanna. I'm gonna just double check everybody up here. Oops, not turn into a problem, please. Everybody should be good. Cool. So if red eyes don't get answered, they basically screech at you. They don't turn into a major problem, really. It's not that they don't turn into a problem. And you want to answer red eyes right away. I'm going to take a quick sweep through for phones, because that's my biggest problem. I always miss phones. Okay, we're good. Oops. Very fun game to play on a mechanical keyboard. Wear it in, get everybody mad at you. Oh. Oops. He also didn't have a seatbelt on. He's also leaning back. I'm gonna double check this front of the plane. Looks good. I'm gonna ignore the red eyes and that buzzer. Hopefully no one's messed up. Okay, good. Where are you? Oh, you're in the back of the plane. Oh. This plane is a big mess. Looks good to me. Okay, thank God. Two more levels and we're clear for takeoff. Oops. Oh boy. Why do you keep taking me in the front? There's another guy in red over there that I didn't get. Take a quick pass. Thank you, Red Eyes. Everyone looks good to me. Okay. Can't see it, but I'm cringing every time the plane gets to where it would crash. Also, level 20 introduces two red eyes, so. Conveniently, they're right next to each other, so we don't have to really worry about them. I'm gonna get both raised eyes. See, that one I was a little too late for, and he became a problem. Double check. I should be okay. Let's see if we are. Of course not. Not on the last level now. It's always a phone. It's never anything else. Just my luck. It's always a phone. He had all three problems. He's a fancy one. Thank you, Red Eyes, for showing me that guy still had his phone out. Sometimes Red Eyes can be bros. Red Eyes, please. Please. I'm calling it good. Hopefully. And that's time. And for our rewards, we get to go to heaven, along with all the other passengers, because it was the pilot's fault and not anybody else's. So yeah, that was Pre-Flight Panic, game by Yahtzee, and I really hope y'all take this in consideration for the schedule.